I am Joan Amara. Welcome to my video on Laplace transform. This is actually part 2. Previously, we did Laplace transform of polynomials, and in this video, we're going to be doing Laplace transform of trigonometric functions. For example, cos and sine. So we're going to be taking their general forms and expressing them in their Laplace transform. Okay, so welcome to my channel. If you've not yet subscribed, please hit the subscription button and the notification bell beside it so you can get more of my videos each time I post. The first function we are going to be taking is what? Cos AX. For this function, we're not going to be doing anything different. I had already defined what the Laplace transform operator look like, so I'm just going to be introducing it here. And everywhere that f of x ought to be, cos ax will be. So we have what? We have the improper integral from 0 to infinity cos ax exponential minus p times x dx. So this is actually the definition of Laplace transform of cos ax. So, but this will be very difficult to integrate without the use of this. So we are going to actually get the limit as some b goes to infinity, integral from 0 to b, cos ax exponential minus px dx. So before we evaluate this, let's just work on getting this side, okay? So to integrate this, if you are familiar with integrating trig function multiplying exponential functions, you will know that you need to name that integral. So for this video, we are going to be naming that integral I. And I is equal to integral from 0 to b cos ax times exponential minus px dx. Now, to do this, we are going to use product rule, as we're going to be taking integral of u dv is equals to uv minus integral of v du. So, we need to choose our u from here and our dv from here. Okay, now, if you are given a trig function and an exponential function, your best choice of u is your trig function. Let u be cos to cos ax. I need to figure out what my du by dx is. What's my du by dx? If I differentiate this, I'm going to use chain rule. So what do I mean? I'm going to keep the function and differentiate it as if nothing is wrong with it. So differentiating, you know what is actually making me say that is this a. Okay, it's going to affect our integral, but I'm going to do it as though it's not there. So I have minus sine ax. Next, I'm going to differentiate this part, and what do I have? I have a. If I differentiate ax, I just have a. Okay, so this will give me minus a sine ax. The next choice of dv, you don't need to choose it, just pick the remaining side, that's everything left here, as your dv. Dv is going to give me exponential minus px dx. All we need to do is integrate this. And since we studied Laplace transform, especially in my previous video, how do we integrate it? If you followed up my last video, if you've not watched that video, please kindly watch it. It's on polynomials. You're going to integrate this, and if you integrate this, you will have what? V is equal to minus 1 over p exponential minus px. Keeping that in mind, how did we get that? You can simply use substitution method. Make this maybe say u or anything you want it to be, maybe s, and then differentiate and then substitute, okay, before you can integrate. Now we're going to put them back into the side of the equation. We have I is equal to integral from 0 to b cos ax exponential minus px dx. This cos ax can be in brackets. Is equal to uv minus integral of v du. So let's find out what our u is and our v is, okay? So uv is actually minus cos ax over p. See, I'm multiplying this two. So minus cos ax over p exponential minus px. So let's write that down. Minus integral of v du. So let's not forget that this winds from 0 to b, okay? So this is integral going from 0 to b. V du, what's our v? So this is our du. So we need to multiply it with v, okay? So I'm multiplying this two. So if I multiply this two, I just have a over p sine ax exponential minus px dx, okay? So let's go and put that into that equation, and we have what? A over p sine ax exponential minus px dx. These are all constant relating to x, because we're differentiating with x. We are seeing all of those as constants. So let's take them out and also evaluate this at b, okay? So this will give me what? So this is equal to minus cos ax, x is b now, over p exponential minus pb minus, I'll put 0 every other place. So cos 0 is what? 0. So minus minus cos 0, this is plus. Cos 0 is 1 over p exponential 0 is what? 1. So I can stop there, right? Minus a over p integral from 0 to b sine ax, let's put this in brackets, exponential minus px dx. So you see that we have an issue here. We still have a product of two functions. We are going to reevaluate that. It's exactly the same thing we did with I. We are going to pick our u and we are going to pick our dv. And we know that our best choice of u is trig function. So u is equal to sine ax. This implies that du is equal to, see, I remove the dx here. I will always multiply it at the other side, okay? So I'm using chain rule here. I have a. I'm differentiating this first. I have a. Then I differentiate this whole function. I have what? Cos ax. Don't forget your dx, okay? Then the dv, like I told you, is actually everything else. That's what we have there. So we have dv is equals to exponential minus px dx. And integrating this, we've done this over and over and over again. In if you still have issues with doing it, you can check the previous videos on Laplace transform of polynomials. So we have v is equal to minus 1 over p exponential minus px, okay? So we're going to be substituting this into this place. When we are through, we'll put it back into the original equation, okay? I just dragged it out so I can see what it really looks like. Equal to uv minus integral of v du. So what's our u and what's our v? Let's check it out. So u is actually this and then v is this, okay? So putting it in, we have minus sine ax over p exponential minus px from what? 0 to b. So that's our uv. Minus integral of v du is what? V du. So we're going to take those two. We have minus a over p cos ax exponential minus px dx. So let's simplify this and then simplify this too. Evaluating that, we have what? This is all, this is equal to, I'm going to be plugging in my values of b. So I have minus sine ab over p exponential minus pb, okay? If I put plug in 0, I don't need to check the rest because sine 0 is 0, okay? Here. If I plug in 0 here, sine 0 is what? 0. Because a times 0 is 0, sine 0 is 0. 0 times anything divided by anything is what? 0. So I don't need to write it at all. I can just move straight to this part. So I have minus times minus becomes plus a over p integral from 0 to b cos ax exponential minus px dx. Yay! Who can see something? I can see something. I can see that this whole thing is my I. Okay? So, indeed, what I have is... So, we are going to be substituting this back into that original function we had. Back to the original equation, and we are here to substitute. This is equal to minus cos a b over p exponential minus pb. I'm not doing anything, I'm just bringing them down. Plus 1 over p minus a over p. The integral of that gave us what? A over p times I minus sine a b over p exponential minus pb. So what do we have? We have that this implies that I, because the whole of this is I, okay? So I is equal to minus, instead of taking the minus first, let's take this first, okay? 1 over p minus cos ab. Now, this has a minus sign, so I can push it down with that minus sign and remove the minus sign. Over p exponential pb minus this times this a squared over this times this p squared. I minus times minus becomes plus a over p squared, the rest of that sine a b over, you see this also has minus, so I'm pushing it down, exponential p b. Now what we need to do is collect like terms. Let this go to the other side. So what do I have? I have I plus a squared over p squared I is equal to 1 over p minus cos a b over p exponential p b plus a over p squared sine a b all over exponential p b. Okay. I guess this is correct. So we need to make I to stand alone and divide 2 by whatever is left. So we have 1 plus a squared over p squared all times I is equal to, so the coefficient of I here is 1. Okay, that's what happened there. Is equal to 1 over p minus the whole of that again. We don't need to add this so that we have it in improper fraction. So adding that, what I will have is over p squared, all over p squared. Okay, 1 divided p squared is p squared, so times 1 is p squared plus a squared. So I'm going to actually push this up here, okay? Taking I to stand alone, what we can do is multiply by the inverse. The inverse is what? P squared over a squared plus p squared. The same thing. P squared plus a squared, the same as a squared plus p squared. Okay? Times the whole of that p. So remember what I is. I is just the integral from 0 to b of cos ax exponential minus p x dx. So that's actually the Laplace of ax, but we are taking it to a finite number. So now instead of taking it to a finite number, we need it to go to infinity. So we take the limit as b goes to infinity of I. Okay, this will give me what? The limit of this whole thing. Okay, at this point we should multiply it. Let's multiply it through. We have what? P over a squared plus p squared minus, I'm multiplying through, this p will cancel this, okay? Because this p times p, one p will go, okay? So we're left with p cos a b over a squared plus p squared exponential p b plus, the same thing will happen, only that p squared will go, totally now. And we are left with what? A over a squared plus b squared. This is multiplying sign ab all over exponential b. Let's put this in bracket. So let's evaluate this. We can see that there is no b here, so this can stand on its own. So this is equals to p over a squared plus p squared. So we are going to evaluate this part now. What does it look like? We have p, this whole side does not have anything related to b, it's just multiplying it, okay? So what do we have about this side? Remember that cosine function is an oscillating function, so it cos x is always less than or equal to 1, okay? So having that, we just know that this part is going to be less than or equal to 1 for any b whatsoever. Even if b goes to infinity, it's going to be less than or equal to 1. We take p to be bigger than 0 and also p to be bigger than a. Now, a is positive, okay? So this whole part goes to 0. Since the exponential function goes to infinity and cos function is bounded by 1. So this goes to 0. Okay. I'm just using that rough explanation for you to be able to easily see that. Okay, so this goes to 0. So I have 0 all here. And then for this place, if you look at it, it's almost the same thing we did here. We have 0 all here. So zero, this goes to 0 also, and we have that our limit is simply this, but p must be bigger than a. Therefore, the Laplace transform of cos ax is equal to p over a squared plus p squared, where p is bigger than a. Now I challenge you to try your best to get the Laplace transform of sine ax. So try to get the Laplace of sine ax. When you are done with that, you will see that your answer should give you a all over a squared plus b squared, and p is also still bigger than a here. So try to get that, exactly the same process. You can replay the video to try to get your sine ax. Thank you for watching this video. If you learned anything, please give this video a thumbs up. I would like you to also subscribe to my channel. Share. Please share the video. And thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. I'm Joanna Mara. Thank you.